God Almighty, we love Him this morning. Hallelujah. Oh, if you love your Jesus this morning, love on your God this morning. We're going to wrap our arms around ourselves this morning and say, we love you, Lord.
Hallelujah, God, I love you, Lord. Hallelujah, oh successful service, a service that will bring joy and will bring praises unto you, Lord. We ask for such a service that no one will forget this service moving on.
Thank you, Jesus.
We pray for the musicians, we pray for all those who came out, we pray for all those who are watching online.
Yes, Lord.
Healing may be delivered on the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
We pray that all those who can't walk will get up and run.
Yes,
we pray that all hands with any sort of disease,
yes,
any
Jesus.
Sort of problem or illness, Lord, will be healed in your name, Lord.
Jesus.
We pray for the word coming forth today, Lord. We pray for
the word
to touch somebody's heart, Lord, so that some soul may be saved.
Yes,
hallelujah!
For his name's sake. Yes, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Amen.
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 And we shall all say, glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, and now and shall be, world without end. Amen. Give God praise and glory. Give God praise and glory. He's your shepherd. And that is keeping you. Amen. You may be seated as our Patrina. Sister Patrina will be coming in to share. Amen. What the shepherd means to her. We're living in a world where people are getting hurt by young people. People are getting murdered by young people. And I'm saying if a young person can fire off a gun, they can sing praises to the Lord.
Amen.
If they can murder their neighbor, they can be a bishop of a church. There's something in youth that is vibrant and full of life and energy, and they are the needle movers, they're the world changers. And we know that if we continue to pray for our youth, great things will happen. And we believe in Brampton Chapel Church of God, just like every other church, that we have the best youth in the nation.
Amen.
The very best youth in the nation. And we just want them to be called out, sold out for God, and that God will do great and mighty things. Let's welcome Sister Katrina, in Jesus' name.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
The songwriter says, I look to you. After all my strength is gone, in you I can be strong. And when melodies are gone, in you I hear a song. We come to you, O Lord. Strike our heart at the root of pine tree in our hearts. Give us the strength lightly to bear our joys and sorrows. Give us the strength never to disown the poor or bend our knees before insolent might. Give us the strength to raise our minds high above daily trifles. And give us the strength to surrender our strengths to you, thy will, with love. Lord, there is no one else in the world who knows everything about us like you do. When we are feeling lower than low, you know us inside and out.
Amen.
And watch us every day as we stumble and fall. But when we give up on our own selfish ways and come to you instead, you are there to hear our pleas. And talk to us in prayer. You give us strength by knowing that you are there, that we are not alone, and no matter what, I know we are loved. So we come to you in prayer, asking for forgiveness and another chance, asking you to help us hold our heads up high and to leave each day new just for you.
Yes.
We as Christians repeat sayings we hear without actually knowing what those sayings actually mean. One of these sayings is that God is my strength. It sounds good, but what does it mean? If you don't know what this means, how can you apply it to your life? How could God be your strength when you're not even sure what it means or look like? The word "oz" means might, strength. Might implies bodily strength, power, and energy. Strength is defined as the power to resist force, the power of resisting attack. This word is found in verses like Psalm 28, verse 7. The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusted in him, and I am helped, therefore my heart greatly rejoices. And with my song, I will raise him.
Amen.
Look out, Oprah Winfrey, here comes Regina Grant. Look out, Michelle Obama, here comes Regina Grant. Come on, give it up for her. She's on her own. Perhaps if young minds or young talents receive this kind of affirmation that we give, they wouldn't be that big of the world today.
Amen.
But we have them, we've won them, we care for them, and by God's grace, we're going to keep them.
Amen.
We know that the best is yet to come in the future.
Amen.
And we know enough to know that the future is now.
Amen.
It's time for the word. The word of the Lord. A word that's coming through not a senior man, but a young man, a teenager, that just turned 17, that just decided to follow Jesus at the age of 7. No turning back. That God chose to fill with his power at the age of 9, and preach at the age of 13. So all of a sudden, if you do the math, he's got 4 years experience, enough to be a degree. But that's just potential. Unless he continues, and unless we continue the ways of the Lord, it won't mean a thing. But with God on the inside of our lives, greater is he that's in us than he that's within the world. Actual man, could you please stand? Virtual man, please remain silent. As it's God's time inside the preacher, and what's on the inside must come out. And we want what is coming out to reach us right where we are. Savior divine, merciful Father, we gather to hear your voice. The voice that makes a difference, that when you speak, it releases our troubled mind and releases are troubling your mind. Strengthen us today through your word. Empower us through your word. Sanctify us
through your word.
Through your word. That we may be the people you designed us to be. We pray for the youth who are listening to their own right now. Give them a spirit to hear and to recognize your voice to be the voice as you minister to the minister. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Without further ado, I present to you the speaker of this morning, our brother, AJ Kay. Welcome.
We have life. That's enough to be glad about. It may not be the brightest day. It may not be the greatest period in our lives, but we have life. Mm-hmm. And we have it more abundantly. So for that, let's just give God praise and glory this morning.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus.
It's a pleasure to be before you all once again. To be up on this pulpit, to have an opportunity to minister to you once more. I thank you in advance for your listening ears, and I thank you all for your time. I know a lot of people don't really want to hear a kid come up and preach or say much of anything, but you guys have been kind enough to hearken your ears unto me. For that, I'm very, very appreciative.
Amen.
I give all honor to our senior pastor and first lady, Reverend Dr. John Walker and Mother Walker. Of course, it's an honor to our associate pastor and our lady Sandra Walker and Pastor O'Neill Walker. To our evangelists, Michelle Gardner, Michael Jackson, and Evangelist Marlene. To our Reverend Roderick Clark and our evangelist Tanya Clark. And of course, I could not go without giving honor to our youth.
Amen.
I thank you all. I'm so glad to see all of your faces here. Today's scripture was already read by our sister Diamond Price. Didn't she do so great? Here I am. I know how hard it was to read in class. So reading up here at the pulpit in front of a whole bunch of people, it's not an easy load to carry. So we gotta give credit where credit is due. The scripture is read, but I will read it once more. As taken from the book of Psalm, chapter 23. And it reads, "The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, and my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord
forever.
Based on the scriptures read, I'll be speaking to you on a theme entitled, The Shepherd and the Shadow. The Shepherd and the shadow. The 23rd Psalm is a beloved psalm written by David. This psalm is quoted often in our daily lives, and you would hear it in almost every church service. You couldn't go to Sunday school and not hear Psalm 23. That's how it's beloved to our hearts. Now, it was written by David.
Come on.
And David was the youngest of eight brothers. If you thought the Jackson 5 was bad. And he was overlooked by many in his youth. When it came to sports teams, he was picked last. If he was to raise his hand to answer a question in class, he'd be overlooked. And if he was riding the bus back home, he'd be the last to get up and the last to get on.
Come on.
He was overlooked, ignored, an outcast. While his brothers were out fighting in the war against the Philistines, while his brothers were out doing the work of the kingdom, fighting with courage and bravery in their hearts, David was responsible for taking care of his father's flock of sheep.
Come on.
Talk about his contrast. And during this time, the job of a shepherd was looked at as a lower class job. It was often reserved for the youngest in the family. Hence why David got the job. Not because of his resume, because he was overlooked. Have any of you been overlooked in your lives?
Come on.
Have any of you been doubted in your lives?
Come on.
Have any of you been talked about in your lives? Overlooked. He's not going to amount to much of anything. She's not the brightest in the class. She's not the sharpest knife in the drawer.
Come on.
Overlooked. Though initially excluded from the rage of war, though initially sheltered from the heat of battles of life and death, David, from a young age, knew what it was to hold lives in his hands.
Come on.
Just in the flock. He knew what it was to guard what was precious to him.
Come on.
He knew what it was to be a leader. Just in the flock. Talk about humble beginnings. During David's time tending to the sheep, he had moments where he had to protect his flock. When a lion came and attacked the vicious beast called the king of the jungle, he grabbed it by its mane and killed it.
Come on.
And when a bear attacked, the vicious, clawed, hungry bear attacked. Looking for food, I don't want some sheep today. I'm feasting. I'm hungry.
Come on. He grabbed
it by the fur and killed it too. Where others would boast in this feat.
Look at me,
I killed the bear.
Come on.
Look at me, I killed the lion. Check out my guns. I'm the king of the jungle.
Come on.
You thought the lion was tough. I'm Michael Jackson bad. Ooh.
Come on.
He boasted. He would boast it. But where others would boast, David knew this was the Lord's doing and his marvelous. This is the Lord's work and not mine. How many of you know humility goes a long way?
Come on, yes, sir. Yes.
Come on.
Humility goes a long way.
Yes.
Humble yourself before God. He will exalt you. When you submit yourself to God, he will exalt you.
Yes.
And just as I said, due to his humility, God exalted David to be king of Israel due to his faithfulness to God. And he was overlooked. Now you got to look at me now. I'm king of Israel.
Come on.
You got to look at me now. I'm king of Israel. I'm no longer overlooked because I humble myself.
No longer undermined. Come on.
He was now a greater shepherd than before once David became king. He was leading a nation of thousands of people. He was guiding a larger flock.
Come on. Come on.
That little boy David could have ever imagined. However, in all of David's authority, and in all of David's royalty, though he was of great monarchy, he did not forget the fact that he was in the care of the ultimate shepherd.
Come on.
Though David had wealth unattainable, though David had influence unbelievable, though David had armies unbeatable,
come on,
he knew he was in the hands of God. That he was in care of a shepherd greater than he is. Greater is he.
Come on.
David had more lives in his hands than ever before. David was not taking care of the sheep anymore. David was ruling a kingdom of thousands of men, women, and children.
Come on.
He delegated. He said, you go here and you go there. He said, armies go that way. Special forces go this way. Servants attend to this. Other servants attend to that. Though David had lives in his hands, uncountable.
Come on.
He did not fail to recognize that his life was in the hands of God.
Come on, amen.
David in his reign. David in his tenure was recognized as a man after God's own heart.
Come on.
We can say he made things personal.
Yes.
He was one who had one of the most intimate relationships with God. As he learned of the ultimate shepherd, he was given the ultimate experience. David said of his shepherd in Psalm 18 that he was his rock and his fortress, his deliverer and his strength, in whom he will trust.
Come on.
Though David was easily the most powerful man in the land of his time, he submitted to a higher power.
Come on.
Who he acknowledged as his superior. David knew how to fight. David could throw a punch. David could swing a sword. David could sling a slingshot. David could shoot an arrow. He knew the taste of victory.
Come on, amen.
But he also knew who delivered him from his troubles. He knew who was his shield in every battle. He knew who was guarding him.
Come on.
David knew the strength of horses, much mightier than a man, with a kick strong enough to fracture skulls, crush bones, and damage intestines with ease. But he knew the greater strength of his shepherd to say in Psalm 20, verse 7, though some may trust in their horses, some may trust in their chariots, I will trust in the name of the Lord.
Come on, come on, hallelujah.
Trust in the name of the Lord.
Come on.
Can we give God praise
and glory?
Can we give honor to his name?
Hallelujah.
Give praises to the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Do you trust him today?
Come on.
Do you have faith in him today? Do you believe in him today? Delving deeper into Psalm 23, let's take a closer look at the verses. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. The first verse of Psalm 23 declares God as the shepherd. And states that because God is the shepherd, we have no need for anything.
Come on.
We don't need material things. We don't need money. We don't need that big fancy heel. God is our shepherd. There's nothing more to ask for.
Come on.
Because God is our shepherd. And when we look at the duties of the shepherd, it's easier to understand while there's no more to ask for. A shepherd's duty is to provide.
Yes, come on.
A shepherd's duty is to feed. A shepherd's responsibility is to give care. And a shepherd's job is to guard.
Yes.
Psalm 23 says with a loud and triumphant voice, the Lord is my provider.
Come on, come on.
The Lord is my caregiver.
Yes.
The Lord is my protector. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not.
Come on, come on, come on.
The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want.
Come on.
We're talking about
the shepherd. Come on, come on.
We're talking about the shepherd. Try to keep up. Moving further into verse 2, we get more insight into what our ultimate shepherd does for us. See, when it comes to tending to a flock, you gotta have some sense to it.
Yes.
It must be ensured that they're in the right environment for them to thrive. Sheep are known for eating grass, and with that knowledge, no good shepherd is going to house their sheep in the desert.
Come on.
This is why verse 2 says, he makes me to lie down in green pastures.
Come on.
He leads me beside the still waters.
Come on.
God, the shepherd, holds his flock in a comfortable position for their well-being, for their development, and for their prosperity. He holds them in conditions that are conducive to their growth and their development.
Come on.
Even if it's not comfortable, you will grow.
Yes, come on.
Even if it's too hot, you will develop.
Come
Even
on.
If it's too cold, too rigid, you will prosper.
Come on.
Verse 3 continues the explanation of the faithfulness of the shepherd. And saying, he restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake.
Come on.
The shepherd is a rebuilder.
Yes.
The shepherd is a restorer.
Yeah.
He refreshes the soul. Mm-hmm. When his sheep, the flock, you and I, have become weary.
Yes.
When we have become weak. Mm-hmm. And he energizes them once more.
Come on.
Has anyone ever caught a second wind? That's what I'm talking about.
Yes.
And upon the restoration, upon the energization, he continues to lead them down the right path. Mm-hmm. The path towards peace.
Come on.
The path towards morality. The path towards prosperity and the path towards a good heart. He does these things for his name's sake. Not because of what we've done, not because we paid the price, not because we're good to him, not because we deserved it, but because that's just who he is. I'm talking about
the shepherd.
The shepherd. In the fourth verse, we're introduced to our dilemma. In other words, our problem. Our situation. We're introduced to the foe of the flock. I submit to you, Church of the Living God, we are more than fortunate to have a shepherd in our lives who tends to us, his flock. However, with every flock, with every shepherd, there is a threat to the flock.
Come on.
The predator.
The predator.
The predator. The predator of our hearts. The predator of our minds. The predator of the spirit. The predator of the soul. The predator of the emotions. 1 Peter 5 verse 8 mentions to us that the enemy is like a roaring lion, walking about, skulking around, stalking, seeking whom he may devour, watching, waiting, stalking, praying. And when you pray, I mean pray.
Come on.
Psalm 23, verse 4 says, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you, God, are with me, and your rod and your staff, they comfort me.
Come on.
This, saints, is where the predator makes
his move. Come on.
In the shadow.
Ah, hallelujah.
We're talking about the shadow. Where the predator is free to roam. Free to do as he pleases. Free to stalk his prey. Free to exploit them in times of weakness. The predator's goal is to enclose you within the shadow.
Isolate you,
of
come
death.
On.
To isolate you within the shadow of death. To withhold you in the shadow of death. Where the shepherd wants to hold you in conditions conducive to your growth. Where the shepherd wishes to lead you beside the waters.
Come on.
And lay you down in green pastures.
Come on.
The predator
yes.
wants to hold you in a position that will compel you to your destruction. The shadow. The predator stalks its prey.
Yes,
the sheep at its most disadvantaged
vulnerable time.
Position. The most vulnerable position. When the flock, when the sheep is in the valley.
Come on.
When the sheep are in the valley, the predator has the high ground.
Hallelujah.
And when
come
you
on.
Have the high ground, you're up high looking low. When you're up high looking low, you're superhuman.
Yeah.
You have something come on. Over them.
Come
you
on.
Have
come
their
on.
Edge.
Come on.
They have a handicap, so to speak. Their hands tied behind their back, or you're free to use whatever weapon you please. They're in the valley. They're disadvantaged. They're weak.
Yes.
Typically, valleys are viewed as places of abundance. Flooding with water, being useful for shelter, flourishing with food. They're usually a space between mountains, a space between the higher ups. When you're up high on the mountain, you feel like you're insurmountable. Inconquerable.
Come on.
When you're up on the mountain, you feel like you can't be beat. I'm on top of the world.
Come on.
Nobody
can touch
me. But when you're
can't touch
in
me.
Valley,
come on, come on.
When
come
you're
on.
Down low.
Yes, come on.
Yeah.
Can't get any lower than this. I can't dig deeper than this. Come I'm on the floor.
Yeah.
I've hit rock bottom. I'm in the valley. In this valley. Of the shadow of death.
Come on.
There's no room for life to flourish.
Come on.
There's no conditions for abundance. There is no shelter. There's no food. There's no water. You're starving. You're hungry. You're tired. Anything you could imagine negative, that's you.
Come on.
Come on.
There is but one thing in abundance in this valley, and that thing is fear.
Fear.
Somebody say fear.
Fear.
Come on, somebody say fear.
Fear.
As children are often afraid of the dark, so are we as sheep overcome with fear in the shadow. As if there being a predator was not enough. The predator does not come empty-handed. He does not come with mercies forevermore. He does not come with fullness of joy. He comes all with the weapon.
Come on.
Of
fear. Come on.
Fear. A state of being known by all men and women and children alike as the most debilitating state. Fear. In this valley of the shadow of death. Fear. In this low point in life and this dark point in time. Fear.
Fear, come on.
In this time of loneliness. fear, heart bursting, adrenaline pumping fear that causes your heart to beat uncontrollably, steadily yet deafening in your ears.
Come on.
Take your hand and come with this. Fear. The predator uses fear as his weapon against us because fear is what disconnects us from God.
Amen.
Fear is what tears us from the green pasture and flings us from the still waters. Mm. When a sheep has total trust in the shepherd.
Come on.
It's comforted in knowing that the shepherd is near. Sheep are meek creatures. They're not that smart. They're not that bright. They don't have much knowledge of their surroundings. They're just meant to follow. They're not all that up here, but they know within their hearts the words of Psalm 23, verse 1. They shall not want, for they lack nothing. The sheep are content in the knowledge that the shepherd is taking care of them. And with that knowledge, nothing else matters. But when fear is struck within the heart of the sheep, when fear gets into the flock, when fear enters the flock,
glory to God.
Then do the sheep flee from the presence of the shepherd.
Yes. Come on.
In our theme for the Refuge Convention, we said the potter is in the house. But when the predator is on the prowl, you can call that a home invasion.
Come on, come on.
When fear gets into the house, when fear gets into the body,
come on.
The heart.
When fear gets into the flock, when the flock has lost its faith,
come on.
It gives into fear in the shadow. Mm. And we're just a step
away
closer to the predator.
Glory to God.
The Bible says in Matthew 17, verse 20, that if we can have faith,
come on,
we can say to the mountain, move from here to there.
Come on.
And it will be.
Amen.
The predator knows how strong we can be if we just have
faith. Exercise.
And that's the exact reason why he wishes to rid us of our faith.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
And he does all this within the shadow.
In the shadow.
As children, many of us were afraid of the dark, and I know some people who still are. Why? We'll be afraid of the dark. Because we feared there were monsters in the shadow. And because we couldn't see. We couldn't see. I can see without things. I'm just using that. A shadow is a place where light does not have its effect. And a shadow is formed when something is blocking out the source of light.
Come on.
Something is blocking out the sun. I don't know if you have seen an eclipse, but it gets dark. And you can't see it all too well. Psalm 84, verse 11 says that God is our sun and shield. So something is blocking our view of God.
Come on.
Come on.
Which is our sun. And we are left in the darkness of the shadow, and we can't see God.
Come on.
We can't see the shepherd. I ask the question, church, what's blocking your faith in God?
Come on.
Where is your faith in God? Why do you lose faith in the shadow? This shadow represents your hardship. This shadow represents your pain. This shadow represents your problems, your heartache, your suffering. You could be faced with issues that you don't think God can get you through.
Come on.
You start to doubt Him because you don't see things changing. You think, this is too much for me. And because it's too much for you, you think it's too much for God.
Come on. Come on.
You think it's too much for God.
She get ready to give up.
Enemies come in your way that you don't think God can protect you. Problems in your life, you just can't see God in them. You could be struggling at school, you just can't meet the mark. Can't get the grade.
Come on.
It's not looking good for you. Credit recovery is a long way. And you don't feel like you can recover. You feel like giving up because it's been going on too long.
Far too long.
Far too long.
Far too long.
You're having a hard time at work, trying day after day to push through this dead end job. It's overwhelming, man. You're just waiting for that breakthrough. You've been seeing the doctor for weeks on end, they can't tell you what's wrong.
What the problem is.
You've been to every physician, they can't tell you what the problem is. They just give you more pills to pop as if that's gonna stop it. They recommend you to this person, they sign off to this person, you can't get help. You can't see your way out of it. You can't see God in it. When we're in the shadow, it's easier to doubt the shadow. When we are in the shadow,
come on,
it's easier to lose our faith in God. When we are in the shadow, it's easier to lose sight of God. And in the shadow, it's easy to let fear conquer
cripples you.
Our faith.
Oh, God.
Yes, glory to God.
However, though we're in the shadow, though we're in a dark time, though we're in the lowest possible point in our life, though we are in the valley of the shadow, this does not stop God from being able to call us out of darkness and into marvelous light. I say to you in the shepherd's flock, I say to you the stray sheep, do not allow the shadow to make you lose faith in your God.
Come on,
you may feel alone in the shadow. You may feel afraid in the shadow. You may feel unsafe in the shadow. You may feel unprotected in the shadow. I don't think anyone's here for me, and I'm in the shadow. I can't see my God, and I'm in the shadow. I can't find my help, and I'm in the shadow. It's too dark, and I'm in the shadow. I'm scared. I'm crippled. I'm paralyzed. I'm afraid. I can't move. I'm in the shadow. The grass that surrounds me, I'm in the shadow. In the shadow, I'm alone. I can't do it. I'm in the shadow.
Come on.
I say to you, Church of the Living God, you're in the shadow. But though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, holding your heart, the Lord is so
kind.
I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me.
Come on,
I'm in the valley. I'll fear no evil. Heavenly, nobody else. out. You put your cup in.
Hey,
you put
on.
Your cup. You get your drink. You pour it in.
Yes.
Peaceful bliss in the shadow.
Yes.
He prepares a table for us in the presence of our enemies.
Come
on. In front of your face.
Come on.
Somebody drives past you, splash mud all over you. God is with you.
Come on.
You look in the puddle, you see your reflection, it looks defeated, but God
is with you.
In the fall, the leaves are dying. Around you, big branches are breaking off. It gets a little windy sometimes.
Yes.
It gets a little colder.
Yes.
You gotta bust out your windbreaker, but God is with you.
Yes.
And in the summertime, through the blazing heat that you can't tolerate, you're sweating a little bit too much, it gets in your eyes, God
is with you.
Yes. In every season
of
our lives, we are assured that God's goodness and God's mercy
will be upon us
eternally. And that the shepherd's flock will be our place of residence forever. Eternally, undeniably, and irreversibly. The shepherd is with us.
Yes.
As he says in Isaiah 46, verse 4 to 5, even to your old age and gray hair, I am he who will sustain you.
Yeah.
I have made you and I will care for you. I will sustain you and I will rescue you. Who will you compare me to or count me equal to? Who will you liken me to that we may be compared? In other words, no one is like me.
Come
this
on.
This is God's name, not me. There's none like me. You can't compare me to somebody else.
Yes.
As saved as Dr. John Walker could be, you can't compare God to me. As fiery, as anointed, as powerful as Lady Sandra may be, you can't compare God to her. As many words as Pastor O'Neill may have to declare the glory of God, you can't compare God to him. We are guarded by an infallible and incomparable shepherd who cannot be likened to anyone else or put up against any other being. I say to you now, church, the shepherd wants you in his word. Within his fold there is protection. In his fold, there is goodness and mercy. In his fold, there is peace. Shadows were not meant to be the be-all and end-all of it. Shadows were not meant to rule us. The light of the shepherd drives away all darkness.
Come on.
The predator comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But the good shepherd said, I have come that you may have life and have it more abundantly. And let me let you know one more thing about the shepherd. You see, shepherds have flocks of possibly hundreds of sheep. And if one goes missing, they will not have to get that. Though they have a multitude, they still care for
that one.
You are that one. He may have many sheep, but he still cares for you all. Will you come to him today?
Glory to God.
I ask the youth, will you come to him today? You may feel alone. You may feel like you're doing it all on your own. You may not know where you're going. You feel like you're just going with the flow of life. You may feel misunderstood, misused, and abused. You may feel afraid of what's to come. And that's normal. As youth, we don't know what to expect in an ever-changing world. We don't know what's to come tomorrow, or next week, or the day after. We know almost nothing in the future. You may be afraid and alone, but no matter what we are going through in our lives, there's a place for you within the shepherd's flock. His arms are always open to you, and he wants you to come in. Take a chance on God today. Take a chance on the shepherd. He won't let you down. God bless you.
People, there are people that just hate you for no reason. And they don't even know you.
Yeah. Yeah.
And they just have it in mind to wipe you out.
Mm-hmm.
Some come as a pack of, like, I don't want to say like a jackal spirit. They come in packs every day to break you down in school, to tell you you're a failure, that you're ugly, that you won't amount to anything. Mm-hmm. Now you may go to the principal and go to your teacher, and because they don't see it, they think you're making it up. You come in with a black eye. And they said you caused it upon yourself. You're looking for answers. You're looking for a way out. And when you retaliate, you're the one that gets in trouble. You're the one that's suspended. But I got good news for you.
Good news.
It's not death. Turn to your neighbor and say, it's just a shadow.
Just a shadow.
Just a shadow.
It appears like it's going to be over for you. It appears as if the best moments are in the past. It appears as if that there's going to be a sudden attack. But you have a shepherd that knows when to strike. Because that same shepherd that nurtures is the same shepherd that will destroy. For every one of you, virtual land, and have your children. Let every thought of your child, your grandchildren, or your godchildren. I want to pray for you. You heard the young preacher. You didn't listen to a 50-year-old man. You didn't listen to a 75-year-old man. You heard your own. Your own speak to you. Your own can address you better than anyone else. You have someone that cares. Don't end your life. Get rid of that. Throw those pills under the toilet.
Jesus. Hallelujah.
That belt that you have no interest in putting around your waist.
Glory to God.
Put it away. Reach out to somebody that cares. And if you feel that nobody cares for you, God would not send this broadcast to your ears. To minister to right to your need right now. Because everybody needs a shepherd.
Yes, sir.
And there's a shepherd that loves you more than anybody else could ever love you.
Glory to God.
Bow your heads and close your eyes, gracious Lord, Father. Shepherd of our souls, we come before you. Somebody is walking through the valley.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Somebody's in a place in their life where they're parched and destitute and they're crying out, but all they hear is their echo. Some are holding their mouths open, but no sound can come out because they're being violated over and over again. They need a shepherd to shift some things in life. Oh, great God of heaven, release your power and meet them right where they are. Somebody's heart has been broken. Someone's been abused. Standing at the crossroad, wondering just what to do. Somebody's life has been shattered. Some grown man has been made to cry.
Hey, hallelujah.
There's a pregnant mother, that a pregnant soon-to-be mother that's just wailing right now. Father God, drugs are rampant around our young people, and they feel that's the way out.
Glory to
God. They're addicted to it because they're addicted to sin.
The shadow, Lord.
But God in heaven, come through.
Yes, Lord, let your light.
Speedily come through. With your rod, with your staff, with your presence, with your bare hands.
Yes, Lord, come through.
God, you see and you know, you're omnipotent, omniscient, and omnipresent. We call on you.
Yes, Lord.
To see your people
through. Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Send them help.
Yes, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Someone's mind is out of control, Lord. Thoughts are racing to do evil, to do harm. But we set forth grace and mercy. We send the word, surely goodness and mercy shall follow. Father, don't just follow them now. We're asking you to take the lead before they do what they have in mind to do. Be there and block it in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
No harm.
Hallelujah. Yes, Lord.
No harm. No harm.
Glory to God.
No harm.
Glory. Not today.
No, Lord.
Not today.
Not today.
Not today.
Not today.
Jesus.
Not another
Jesus.
Not another grandchild.
Yeah. Lord.
Sign, seal, deliver my Calvary.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Amen.
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 Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Shepherd,
yes,
that's going to meet you.
Hallelujah.
At the pool of the reed.
Glory to
look
God.
To him.
Yes, Jesus.
Because he will look after you.
Amen.
Yes,
amen.
Lord.
God, which you bless you. Come next week, viewing audience. Come next week for Family and Friends Day. Reverend Julia James from Revival Time, Christian Ministries Worldwide, will be ministering. Amen. As well as we're going to have some special guests for praise and worship. You don't want to miss it. It's our Thanksgiving service. It's Family and Friends Day. Amen. And we're having a christening too. So come on out and bring your babies, because we have enough ministers to bless each and every one of you. May the good Lord bless you in Jesus' name. And remember, despite the shadow, you have a shepherd in Jesus' name. Give the God.